Today we are going to read how to use a package. So let's get started. Using a package. Let us now consider some simple programs that will use package from other packages. This listing below shows a package named package 1 containing a single class, class A. This source file should be named class A.java and stored in the subdirectory package 1 as stated earlier. Now compile this Java file. The resultant class A.class will be stored in the same subdirectory. Now consider the listing shown below. This listing shows a simple program that imports the class class A from the package 1. The source file should be saved as package test1.java and then compiled. The source file and the compiled file should be saved in the directory of which package 1 was a subdirectory. Now we can run the program and obtain the results. During the compilation of package test1.java, the compiler checks for the file class a.class in the package 1 directory for information it needs. But it doesn't actually include the code from class a.class in the file package test1.class. When the package test1 program is run, Java looks for the file package test1.class and loads it using something called class loader. Now the interpreter knows that it also needs the code in the file class a.class and loads it as well. Now let us consider another package named package 2 containing again a single class as shown below. As usual, the source file and the compiled file of this package are located in the subdirectory package 2. This program shown below uses classes contained in both the packages and therefore it imports package 1 and package 2. Note that we have used star instead of explicit class name in importing package 2. Importing classes from other packages. This program may be saved as package test2.java, compiled and run to obtain the results. The output will be as under. When we import multiple packages, it is likely that two or more packages contain classes with identical name. Example, we may import and use these packages like import pack1.star, import pack2.star, semicolon, student n1, semicolon. Since both the packages contain the class student, compiler can't understand which one to use and therefore generates an error. In such instance, we have to be more explicit about which one is intended to use. Example, it is also possible to subclass a class that has been imported from another class. This is illustrated by program 11.2. This output will be class B m equal to 10, class C m equal to 10, n equal to 20. Note that the variable m has been declared as protected. A subclass is another package can inherit a protected member. It would not have been possible if it has been declared as either private or default. Subclassing an imported class. While using packages and inheritance in a program, we should be aware of the visibility restrictions imposed by various access protection modifiers, as pointed out earlier. Packages act as container for classes and other packages, and classes act as container for data and methods. Data members and methods can be declared with the access protection modifiers such as private, protected, and public, as well as default. The effect of use of these modifiers was discussed in detail in Chapter 8. For the sake of easy reference, the access protection details given in table and reproduce table 11.2. Access protection. If you want more videos like this, then let me know by hitting that like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.